Drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds, doing tussy slides in both ears. Dice falling on the Las Vegas strip tonight. Slip that on and we might miss the fight. Fuck or not, I keep the guala in my shorty bag. You know she one of mine when she tattooed that ass. I'm a lover boy.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Why do I look like this? Anyways, it's currently 10 food. Oh yeah, sorry. We're doing a week in the life because this week has very exciting things, especially on Friday. I'm doing my first. We normally have flea markets in school where people like sell things, and I'm participating in my first one, and I'm selling chocolate chip cookies. Yani, okay, I'm just like, this idea just popped in my mind, I think during my attachment, during our holiday. And I just got this feeling of making cookies. I've tested a million recipes, and my family is just like, Kezia, enough. You have used enough blue band, enough sugar, enough flour, enough eggs. Enough is enough. Whatever is the best so far, just use that. And I think I have settled for one recipe, which is exciting, and I can't wait. Yani, Friday, I just can't wait. Today is Tuesday, so I have Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday is a D-Day. And it's so exciting. And my family is also coming back. Okay, it's not related to the flea market. But my family is also coming to Nairobi this week. My dad and my brother and my nephew are coming today, and then my mom comes on Thursday. So that's gonna be exciting. But yeah, anyways, yesterday on Monday I didn't do much, just had one online class, and then what else did I do? Actually nothing, I just had the online class and then just chilled the whole day. So today we have three online classes. I've just finished the first one, and then we have another one from 12 to 1, and then another one from 2 to 4. But my dad is coming at around like upper lunchtime, so he'll be here at around 2, so I need to make lunch, and I think I'll just do like a beef with ugali or something. I feel like making rice, but I'm like, no, we'll do ugali with beef. So yeah, I've kind of become an ugali expert. So yeah, we're gonna make that. But for now, I do want to edit a video so that I can have one up on Sunday. Yeah, so today's plans is just classes, nothing else actually. But for now, I want to make breakfast. I don't even know what I'll eat. I can either make corn dogs or we can do ramen. I've become a corn dog fanatic. Okay, is that the right word? Let me just check the meaning of fanatic before I start calling myself things that I'm not. Fanatic. Person filled with excessive and single-minded zeal, especially for an extreme religious or political cause. Filled with excessive zeal. Yes, I'm a corn dog fanatic. We made corn dogs. The first time, I think my sister made corn dogs like kitambo, and then also I've tasted corn dogs from Rara's Kimchi on Instagram. She's based in Mombasa. She has amazing corn dogs, by the way. So if you are in Mombasa, if you do go to Mombasa, it's not even, just okay. Yeah, just order corn dogs from Rara's Kimchi. They're really nice. Tell her that I sent you. This is what I'm serious. Tell her that Kezia sent you. So yeah, what else? So the options are corn dogs, ramen, or corn dogs, indomie. We also have cookies, or I could just eat fruits. I don't know. We can just do all of them, by the way. See, I think no restrictions. If I do ramen, I made this ramen, this viral ramen hacks that were on TikTok for egg, mayo, garlic. Egg, mayo, garlic, the spice packets, and you mix them, and you add the hot indomie water, and then you add the indomie, and it was so good. But everyone was coming at me for the raw egg, and I was like, y'all can't even taste the rawness of the egg. You can't even taste the egg. So it's like, okay, but like, this is crazy. But anyways, I think today I'll do either the peanut butter one. Let's just go and check if we do have peanut butter, because I'm not sure we have peanut butter. If we don't have peanut butter, but I'm like, I think when I just eat, I may not feel like eating the corn dogs right now, but once they enter my mouth, I'm gonna be super excited. So I don't know, I really need to use my tripod stand so that like you guys can see me, but I'm lazy to do that. Oh, we also have, okay, wait me. So as I was saying, oh my gosh, I look so nice. Anyways, as I was saying, I made kondog butter on, when did we make kondogs? I think ever since I ate them at Rara's Kimchi. Okay, but currently, let me just tell you the date, April 18th. So I came to Nairobi last week, Wednesday, and it's Ramadan. So in Mombasa, Ramadan is a big thing, and currently there's this whole market that's going on in Makadara, and we went that night and we ate the kondogs from Rara's Kimchi. So since then, I was like, I really want to make kondogs myself. And I also, yani, I went to the extent of even wanting to like sell kondogs at the flea market, but I was like, one, sijui kupika na ako kajiko kadogo that you can carry, the portable one. I know, but like I want to test it and be confident in it. And then also the kondogs, I really thought it would be like an easy thing. Kisa your oil is heating up and you're here making stories. So I think I made them on, which date is this? Ah. Oh my gosh, which day was this? 15th April, and 15th April was just the other day, on Saturday. So yeah, I made the butter on Saturday. Did I make more? Yeah, I did make more. I wanted to eat them for dinner, I think yesterday, and then the psych issued after I made the butter, so that's that. So yeah, right now I'm just going to make that, and then I'm just going to make the corn dogs, and then I have some cookies over here. So I'm just going to have kind of a platter, which is just a weird platter because cookies, corn dogs, and watermelon have no collaboration with each other. But anyway, what has to be done has to be done. So yeah, let me just position you guys nicely so we can make this corn dogs. So this is our butter, which is just it's just flour, baking powder. Okay, let me tell you the exact ingredients so we can just make both of our lives easier. 1 cup of flour, 2 tablespoons of sugar, two teaspoons. Okay, I forgot, and I thought I'd actually remember them, but it's flour, baking soda, egg milk, what else? Egg, milk, sugar. Why is this thing breaking? So yeah, anyway, so you just poke the hot dog, then we have it there, and then we're gonna dip it in this mix. You need a spoon, and the oil is hot. You have to make sure like the whole hot dog is covered so that you're cooking the butter and you're not directly frying the condo, the beef venus. Yeah, you can have them and add like cheese, but like I don't really like cheese. And then this cheese that we bought is like extra, like it's fresh cheese, like you can taste the milk and all the ingredients. But then with the because this is the, I'll just check the recipe, the paper. But like Sirmon, S-I-R-M-O-N cheese doesn't taste like milk. It tastes like processed cheese. I don't know if you understand me. But like if you made homemade cheese, it would like taste like milk because cheese comes from milk. So this cheese that we bought tastes like that. It's like homemade natural cheese, which is a good thing. But then it's also a bad thing because we're so used to like supermarket things. The oil is not even hot. Watch that too. And the worst thing about cooking with an hot oil is that now your things soak up oil more than they should. Anyway, this is a whole class that I did not think it would be, but why is this thing not becoming straight? Okay. Oops. So yeah, there's the corn dog.
This is the cheese I'm talking about. This cheese
is as fresh as could be. It's a happy cow. It just tastes like homemade cheese.
It just tastes like milk. Which is a very, very, very nice thing. But I'm saying it as a bad thing because I'm not used to cheese from the shop tasting like that.
That's one of them cooking. How many dishes do you want to butterfly? It should cook till brown on both sides. So, I'm gonna give that some time. One thing I didn't know that my sister told me, because when we're tasting this, it's like it just tastes like mandazi-ish. So, you can use the same butter to make drop scones. So you just drop the butter in the frying pan and then they'll just cook and you'll have like two mandazis, two drop scones. So yeah, that's another advantage of this thing. I think we'll also do that because now our hot dogs are over and we could either buy more hot dogs or use this for drop scones. I think I'll actually save it because now see my family is coming, so you'd think I'm the mom. Not my family, like, but it is mine. So. Cause it's not yours, it's mine. The first time I made this, I thought my butter was so runny, so I added more, and that was the worst thing I could have ever done. Because now, it was just a disaster, so I'm gonna leave this here. Okay. So, this one's a little terrible. I have not yet known how to make the nini, like, the issue is my butter, definitely, because it's just meant to be straight. But now look at this. Look at this. But anyways, no problem. I don't allow watermelon wastage. You better cut every bit of the watermelon out because we're not wasting anything when it comes to watermelons. Yeah, see? So we have our watermelons.
So loving, so loving. So yeah, that's what we have for breakfast. So I think I was telling you guys that I'll watch, because now I have 10:40 and then 11:40 and then my class. So I think I have like an hour. I can start watching that movie. And then it's an hour of class and then another hour break, so that's not bad. But we're gonna try out our corn dogs and see if they're giving, but they're not giving. So yeah, it's a little fork. Yeah, watermelons. I am one big sucker for watermelons, and I'm those people who, when we buy a watermelon, I want to cut up the whole of it into cubes. So that, okay, not into cubes, just cut it all up so that when I'm hungry, I just go and grab a watermelon. I feel like you guys are too high. I'm like half of the frame instead of being like all of it. Anyways, let's just try our corn dog and then we can watch our movie. something's different. It's less crunchier than that first one. Let me show you guys how the first one looked. The first one was so nice. This one, it's less crunchy, but I also think it's better with panko breadcrumbs. Definitely. This is how the first ones looked. Like that. Are you guys actually seeing anything? But yeah, that's how they looked. This one's just flat. Anyways, see you guys in the second class. My battery is dying. I can literally eat out the outer part, like the drop scones, and then just eat the bifanas. But together it's better, definitely. No, but she dies, it will just end. So. You got me out here thinking I was mid. Like, I was not that girl. I was not that Zaza. Anyways, so it's currently 12:36 and our class has not even started. We haven't even received our link because it's not in the timetable. So we're just chilling. I'm having wows. Anyways, what would you like to come and see? I think I need to go shower. If a class is not happening, that's when my dad comes. Let me just see my family. When my family comes, they'll find me like set and ready. And it's getting cold and I'm in shorts and it's freaking cold. So yeah, I think I'll go shower. I'll just defrost. I've removed the beef so that it can defrost because we're making, I think, I know I wanted to make ugali, but I think I'll make rice with beef stew. Just a classic. And also with the rice, I can make the rice tomorrow as fried rice for lunch. You know, with rice you can multi-purpose. With ugali, you have to eat the same freaking meal every single day at a kibaki. Yeah, I was to watch Awake and then I went to Netflix. My friend Chelsea, you guys have seen her in the previous vlog, because in the previous vlog she is there. I haven't posted it yet, but she is in that. By the time this is going up, that one will be up, so she's the one you saw in the previous vlog. And she told me about Love is Blind. I don't even know what you were talking about. And then she was just like, yeah, you should go and watch. I think I asked her what I should watch, or she just mentioned it. I don't really remember. But she's like, yeah, you should watch Love is Blind and just watch season 4. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna trust you. I will never, like, I would have never watched Love is Blind. But I've just finished watching, like, I finished the whole season in 2 days. I watched, like, I think on Friday night, the first 6 episodes. And then Saturday morning, I watched the last 6 episodes. Then I came on Netflix and I'm seeing that the Love is Blind reunion is up. And I'm like, what? So now that's what I'm watching. I've watched like 48 minutes of it. And it's giving what it's meant to be giving. If you've never watched Love is Blind, please go watch Love is Blind. I don't think I'll ever watch season 1, 2, 3. But you can start from season 4. Like, maybe you'll still be excited. So, yeah. I will see you guys when I have showered and I'm cooking supper stroke lunch. But let me ask my sister. This semester I just told myself, because yeah, let's actually look at the number of clothes you have and just think straight for a minute, because you don't really need new clothes. I counted my shirts yesterday, like on Tuesday last week. I have 24 shirts that I can wear to school. 24. That's like, and mind you, I'm just going to school for 3 days per week. So those are a whole 2 months. I can wear shirts for a whole 2 months without repeating. And but no, I'm there saying I want to go and buy new clothes. But I do need to buy pants. I just want black pants. The black pants I have can't be worn. I can't tuck into the black pants that I have because the waist is big. So I want to buy like just one pair.
of black pants, and that's it. Now maybe, like, I save the money to buy shoes because I want to buy boots and loafers. Oh, I don't think I want to buy. Anyways, let me ask my sister when exactly my parents are going to arrive.
I've just arrived. Where has that wow dropped?
Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna go home and go get ready for the day. Not how the day's already over. But yeah.
She bought her toys, keep it coming with my love. It's that roll myself a chain and count my figure shit. It's that stepping out.
We've just finished our class and I want to, because I entered late, and the time I was like 5 minutes late, and then by the time I was entering, because I was still like dressing up when I was in class, I was getting ready while I was joining the while I was in class. I came out of the bathroom, I came out of showering, joined the class, then I got ready as the class was going on, so I wasn't able to write my notes at that time. So I'll just come to e-learning and I want to now like read as I write my notes because I'm a serious girly like that. And then we have some use cases the lecturer has told us to look at, and then we also have an assignment that he's going to check on tomorrow. I think there's also an assignment to be given in the morning, like not assignment like questions. But yeah, that, and then we can go and finally cook dinner. I'm not sure my family will come today because there have been issues with the flights, but we're still gonna do the rice and beef stew. So even though it's just me and my sister, we're still gonna have an amazing meal. So yeah, it's currently 4:06, so hopefully by 5 I'll start cooking. By 5. But yeah. She has a man of dark skin. Let's talk. So I've just seen this video. Okay, wait. And this chick is posting for us a hidden gem. It's all the way in Kitsuru. Nani anafika uko? But anyway. There's this chick who did this video where she was saying nini watu wa food influencers mna tuambianga pa hidden gems, lakini those hidden gems mna tudangana tini 1500 per person. Ukifika uko, the bay is like 3000 a person, so people should stop lying. So now this chick is saying that hidden gem in Kitsuru is 1500 per person, and people in the comments are like, uko shua ni 1500 mna tafika uko alafu nipate ni 3000, 4000. Mind you, kufika iyo hidden gem yenyewe is a whole journey, because what, let me just check for you guys, a bolt from where I live let me say a bolt from school, from Strathmore to Kitsuru new gem zero, will I even find it, 020 Barcelona, 020 Kitsuru, Kitsuru is spelled Kitsuru. What am I? It's Kitsuru. Kitis. Oh my days. So Uncle Grill is also in Kitsuru, whatever. And it's 600 to get there. So I get there with 600. I come back with 600, that's 1200. I eat for 1500. And I'm sure 1500 is not inclusive of drinks. Because, ayapana. Anyways, this is one of the reasons why, because I also do food reviews on Instagram, by the way. Go check me out. And I don't like posting about prices. I'm like, okay, I've started. Okay, there's this series that I'm doing for solo dates in Mombasa for under 2000. That one I'll post prices because I'm telling you, like the title is under 2000. You need to know what you can get for under 2000. But other than that, me, I'm never gonna like. I don't like it. If you want to go, go. If you don't want to go, don't go. Don't let the price of the place determine whether you're going to go or not. Like, okay, I know money plays a big factor because even for me, before I go somewhere, I have to check like the menu and all these things. But like, I don't want to be the one to tell you if it's cheap or affordable. At cheap or affordable or expensive, you just see, okay, I want to go to Ankole Grill, go to Ankole Grill's page, look at their menu, then decide for yourself. Don't decide based on what me I'm telling you, because nowadays the word cheap and affordable does not have the same meaning to everybody. Because cheap ya mtu ama affordable ya mtu ni 1500, because everyone is always saying affordable places and the budget is 1500 per person, but to another person affordable is 500 max. So you can't be telling people you're affordable and you're saying 1500. Like, just say 1500. If you're going to mention the price, just mention the price and don't tag it as affordable or whatever. Yeah, and not even qualifies a place to be a hidden gem. Like, is a hidden gem a good place that hasn't been identified by people, or is a hidden gem a place that is hidden, that is a gem? I don't know what's the difference between the two things that I've just said. But kuna, like, sasa ni kama mtu aseme Kokito is a hidden gem. Like, it might be a gem, but it's not hidden. I think that's why no one has ever called it. I don't even know what I'm saying at this point. Anyways, let's get back to reading because movies on TikTok are the best. Yeah, the best place to watch movies is TikTok. Part 1, Hadi Part 189. Amazing. Ooh.
Like I'm that nigga shit. I drop 30 on this room, we ain't gon' sleep for shit. If I catch you nodding off, then it's gon' be some shit. But you can do what you wanna, live how you wanna, spend what you wanna, be who you wanna be. But I'm stunner till I die.
Going on two parts, like how many minutes later? 10 minutes later, I don't even know what's going on, and the movie has had no meaning. Like, anyways, now let's be serious and actually start reading. Hopefully,
I just run it up before I go. Would you tell them all my secrets if I let you close? These days over my age, it's been past ten.
Hi guys, so today is Wednesday and good morning. It's so early. I have never been this early for school in my life. Yes, my class is not in phase one. I am so excited. Actually, the way I hate going to phase one, our school has two phases, and where we park our cars is phase two. And walking from phase two to phase one is not even a joke. So I am super excited. All my classes are in phase two. Yes. Danny, how you feel? I feel like $100 of money. Anyways, I am so early. I have never been this early for school, but this is why I decided to be waking up at 7, at 6:45. And then I can shower at 7. Mona, I'm out of breath.
But yeah, and then also today's the first time I'm wearing a skirt. I have never worn a skirt to Strathmore. And it's scary. It's not even a joke. But the skirt is big. The skirt is the right size. I'm sure I can't be sent back. And if I am, that is honestly racism. There's nothing else I'm going to say. And they will have to write an essay explaining why they're sending me back. Because in my own opinion, I look snatched. So I also don't know if I should carry my laptop for my online class. Or I should just use my phone. I think I'll carry my laptop because I think I'll stay in school. We have a class from a physical from 8 to 10, 10 to 12. And then we have an online from 12 to 1. No, I'm not carrying my laptop because this lecturer might not attend the online. He will, but I think I'm okay with joining my phone. I honestly have no problem. So yeah, we're just going to carry two books and my phone. So I think we'll also make breakfast because we have the time. So why not? We're going to make French toast. And I also packed a few things to carry to school today. Karibu muende na microwave. Danny, how you feel?
I feel great. Lila, how you feel? I feel like 100 bucks, Danny. So, this is a skirt. Okay, I'll show you guys with a better view, like somewhere else. But this is what I'm going to carry for my snack. So we have this. Are just wows, wow crepes. Wows, not crepes, they're just wows. And in here I have apples and oranges. So yeah, that's gonna be my lunch stroke, breakfast stroke snack. But for breakfast, like actual breakfast, even though I won't eat it, I just want to have it so I can carry it. We're going to make French toast. I used to hate French toast, but then while I was working during attachment, it wasn't the easiest thing per se, but it was one of the easiest things to make for breakfast, and I could literally just carry it and go. So yeah, so I'm gonna make that.
Danny, how you feel?
I'm great. Level, how you feel? I feel like 100 bucks, Danny.
I feel like 100 bucks because I'm, yani, sina stress. Atis, kizia hana stress ya shule.
I'm so satisfied for you. I do that 3-4 times again, I testify for you. I'm so that like you, that bitch, I do it all and I'm around, you're skidding. I'm not, long if you joking, now here for me, I ain't got it. I've been scheming, looting, hide your bodies. Long as you dreaming about me, ain't no problem. I don't got nobody just with you right now. But the truth, I look better under you, I can't lose. When I'm with you, can us lose, you missed the moment. You just so important. Nobody like you do. I can't lose when I'm with you. I can just lose, you missed the moment. You just so important. Nobody like you do. In a top tie ride with you.
I feel like I'll get out of this house and be hit by another cold that I'm not prepared for. I'll just put this one inside a bag because of the moisture emission. Let's pack my lunch. This is our toast. I'm really giving nothing. Just going to bite-sized pieces. That one might not even fit because this container is so tiny. Then we'll obviously drizzle with some honey, which I cannot see.
Well, I can't stand honey. I'm going to cry. Because what's a French toast without honey?
Oh. When you want things that are just right in front of you, you never see them. Hey, 7:57. Sasa nimeovado. Let's get out of this house. Then I'll talk to you guys after I'm done with both my classes. Because I do have a few errands to run. Then I'm coming home early because my parents are going to be here. Yeah, now let's get out of this house. Are y'all ready, kids? Aye aye, Captain. I can't hear you. Aye aye, Captain. Ooh. He lives in a pineapple under the sea. SpongeBob SquarePants. I feel like this should also go into the paper bag. But for now, I'm just gonna push it to the bottom.
But yeah, the skirt is super long, super fit for travel. Let's go and enjoy ourselves in school. I will see you guys after my first class. Bye.
Hi guys. So skirt day one was a success. Oh my gosh, I have loved wearing a skirt to school, and I think I'll wear a skirt every single day. Like, it's so nice. It's just nice to be free and, you know, just be relaxed. It's amazing. Anyways, I've loved wearing a skirt, so I think every Wednesday will be a skirt day for me. See, I didn't have a skirt mingi sana, but I think like I can interchange. Every Wednesday will be a skirt day for me. The guy whose car has squammed. And it had to be like pushed and like jump started, but I think it's okay now. Anyways, a classmate of mine has helped. Now the soldiers are like congratulating him and like appreciating him. Anyways, so it's currently 3:09. My dad and my brother and nephew Fikad, they're already at home. So I think because I just needed to buy blue band for the cookies, and I need to go to like a wholesale shop and buy the margarine that I'm actually using Prestige because it's way cheaper than Blue Band, and it's kind of better than Blue Band if we're really being honest. Okay, is there a difference really? It's just I think the price point that's different, and then at the wholesale shop it's 100 bob less than the price at the supermarket, so we'll do that. And then I'll also go to Quick Mart and buy chocolate, but I want to see if I see only Nikifika Quick Mataki. I don't know why I'm seeing it like such a hassle. And I'm just telling myself we can buy this thing online, even though I know the price won't be the same, especially because of delivery fee. But I'm not really feeling like going to Quick Mart. So we'll just go to the wholesale shop. I'll buy my margarine and then come back home and meet my brother and nephew, who I'm so excited to see. I've missed up. Yani, I just came to Nairobi the other day, but I've been with them for a whole 3 months, so obviously even a minute without them is like so long. So yeah, and then I'll see you guys tomorrow because I don't know what I'm going to cook for supper, and I don't think I'm going to record anything. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. We have an 8 a.m. class again. Actually, tomorrow is just such a terrible day, in all honesty, because we have classes, an 8 to 10 class, and then we have a, like, I think 2-hour break, and then we have a 2:15. An 8 to 10 and then a 2-hour break, and then we have a 12 to 2 and then a 2-hour break. No, and then a 1-hour break, and then a 3 to 5. Like, make it make sense. Make it make sense, sir. But anyways, today has been an amazing day. It's been a good day. So I'll see you guys tomorrow on Thursday. Bye.
I feel like Scarface. That white bitch with the bob, I'll be your main one. This chase, this argument back up to my place. Sex remind you I'm not violent, I'm your day one. We had shit, yeah. It was magic, yeah. Smash and grab shit, yeah. Nasty habits take a hold when you're not here. Ain't a home when you're not here. Are they growing when you're not here? I'm saying I'll kill you.
when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? You just too important. Nobody do body like you do. I can't breathe when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? You just too important. Nobody do body like you do. You do.
To just ending the vlog and forgetting about it, but today was a really nice so I was so close to ending the vlog without even telling you guys what happened today, but it was a really nice day. But the vlog is going to end today instead of ending tomorrow, because tomorrow is a holiday and we're not doing the flea market anymore, which is really really sad because I had so much energy and I was so ready for it. But we're doing it next week. So I don't know if I'll just do it as a vlog on its own. But I'll think about it. But yeah. I'll start another vlog tomorrow for our 3-day weekend with my family. Because my whole family is now going to be half of the weekend. It's going to be really nice. Because now it's Friday, Saturday and Sunday. But today was a really nice day. We stayed in school from 8 until 5. I vlogged in school. And you guys have seen my friends. And yeah. I hope you enjoyed the vlog. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.